good afternoon to everyone. I just discussed the experience with the University of Calgary about CCS. I am assistant professor of the Department of Mechanical, Chemical and Materials Engineering. It's a small department in the University of Calgary. We are about 11 professors, 14 assistant professors, 12 assistant professors, and 10 of researcher fellows and PhD students. In particular, our group is the Energy Environment System Group. Two professors, one associate professor, some research fellow and PhD student. And we are in close collaboration with the Fluid Machinery Group, with three professors. Which are the main research of our group? The main research are process analysis of fossil fuels power plants integrated with CCS, renewable energy sources, in particular biomass and concentrated solar power, and thermal energy storage. In particular, I will show you some of the research activity in the field of CCS that we have the last year. This activity is carried out with strong collaboration with Soda Carbon Enea from about 20 years ago, and this collaboration is not limited to the CCS field. In particular, this is the activity, the recent project that, about CCS that we developed together with Soda Carbon and Enea. The first one is the modeling simulation of Fischer-Dieskau gasification process and syn gas treatment system. We have also a project about modeling, testing, and assessment of post-tre and oxy-combustion CCS technologies for the reduction of CO2 emissions from thermal power plants. Analysis of the integration of ultra-supercritical steam power plants equipped with CCS and integrated with the solar concentration system. Analysis of the integration of post-combustion CO2 capture plants with renewable energy sources. And finally, modeling evaluation of solar energy conversion process based on ultra-supercritical power plant and ICCC technologies with purification of the gas sequence and with CO2 removal. These are the last lesson project about CCS in low carbon system. This one is the first one, the last one that we have finished is a modeling simulation of the ultra-bag gasification process and syn gas treatment system. We can just see is a project funded by the program agreement Ministry of Economic Development with the Enea as a partner. Which are the main goals of this that we have obtained with this project? The improvement of the zero dimensional simulation model for evaluating performance of small gains updraft classifier. The use of this model to support the design of a soda carbon test. Modeling of the syn gas treatment and CO2 capture systems from the simulation. Use of these models to integrate, to optimize the integration between the gasifier and the system of purification and decarbonization of the gas. Here, just some publications that we have obtained with the results of this project. Paper in QLS and one paper of the CCT conference that I think many of you know. Another project was the modeling, testing, and economic assessment of post-pre and oxy-combustion CCS technologies with the aim of reducing the CO2 emissions. You can say that the main goals as a comparison in terms of technical and economic assessment of different post-pre and oxy-combustion CCS technologies. So in particular, the post-combustion was studied with reference to an ultra-supercritical steam power plant. The pre-combustion was studied with reference to an ICCC power plant. and oxycombustion with oxy-fuel steam power plant. We study on different oxycombustion plants, first, second, and third generation. We have seen what kind of plants are this one. Also, yeah, we just have some publication in fuel applied energy and energy in Journal of Energy Research. This one was another typical another model, another project that we have developed is the analysis of the integration of ultra supercritical power plant with CCS and integrated with concentrated solar power plants, in particular with parabolic flux collector for the solar field. Which is the main goals of this project? Evaluation of the benefits from the integration of concentrated solar system into coal-based ultra supercritical power plant with CCS, because we know that solar energy is developing, but it's difficult also to integrate with to build a plants that works only operate only just with solar, because you have the sun is not always present, so you need a thermal energy storage to allow the plants to work when there is no sun. And so the main idea is to integrate a small solar field to increase the power of the plant fed by fossil fuels. So the main goals are the analysis of different integration between the CO2 solar system, CO2 capture section, and the concentration solar field. So which is the best choice between parabolic flux collector and linear plant collectors, and also an analysis which is the best integration between the solar field and the steam and the steam power plant. So where to extract the steam from the power plant. And also obviously the last one was the analysis of the performance of the plant located in different location. Obviously, if you are near the equator, you have more sun, and it's easier to produce to integrate the solar field with the power plants. Also, yeah, we have some application in energy conversion management in the World Renewable Energy Congress. The last two different projects are all of them are. All of this project that I presented are the first project financed by the Research of Electrical System, the RESAE. And this one is the modeling and evaluation of coal energy conversion process based on ultra supercritical energy technology, gas cleaning, clean up, and CO2 removal process. This one is a project that was made some years before the second one that I have presented. So we have just a comparison between ultra supercritical and ICCC without the oxy-fuel combustion. So we can just go away. Some paper that we have written about with the results of this project. We have some other past research activity in the field of CCS, in particular, many of them, all of them are financed by the research of RSA, are about the study. The first one was a thermal conversion of process of coil with a treatment of the gas, an advanced CFD approach for the simulation of entrained coal gasification process. Modern testing of the water gas shift reactor process on sea gas from coal gasification using CO2 gasification methods, and technology of the use of full variety of coal in CCS and modeling process for CO2 reactions. Some paper that we published with these results. Yeah, just some scheme, just to show that we have mainly studied these processes using gate cycle software and Aspen software that we are using in mechanical and chemical engineering for simulated power plant and chemical processes. We have just an experimental facility about the water gas shift reactor. The problem with this one was an interesting facility, but now it's not working, it's not great because we don't have a technician, some PhD that was working on this. It was a circular shift facility with two reactors, high temperature reactor and low temperature reactor. The first one at 500 Celsius, the second one at 300 Celsius degree. You can operate with one or both reaction stages, and you can have different molar ratio between water and CO up maximum up to 5. And you can just use this shift reactor with conventional or platinum catalysts. And so these are the main activity on CCS. I give you also the presentation. So in the presentation there is some other slide that is that show the research activity of our group in the field of renewable energy and the field of thermal energy storage, but now it's out of topic, so it's not interesting to present, but if you want to check, you can from the presentation. Okay, thank you for